Hi, I'm Kieran McKee. Welcome to my channel on scientific writing. In this video, I'm going to show you how to convert chapters from your thesis or dissertation into journal articles. Published peer-reviewed articles are essential to a successful academic career. For many of you, the first paper you will publish will likely come from your dissertation or thesis. Such a pathway differs from writing a manuscript from scratch. On the one hand, the chapter is already written, which seems to be an advantage. On the other hand, the chapter is part of a larger narrative and sometimes requires major revision to produce a standalone article that is publishable. Students often make the mistake of thinking this process involves just copying and pasting the text from the dissertation and reformatting the references to create a paper for publication. That practice often results in a rejected manuscript and comments about the unsophisticated nature of the submission. The problem is that you are dealing with two different audiences, a dissertation versus a journal article. You wrote your dissertation for your graduate committee to show them how much you know about your topic and that you've attained the necessary research skills to get a degree. A journal article must be written for a scholarly audience of peers and needs to convince the editor and reviewers that the work is important and will be of interest to readers. A dissertation chapter is part of a longer narrative and is read alongside other chapters, providing the broader context, whereas a journal article must stand on its own. Your dissertation must be only as good as other dissertations written by fellow students at your university, whereas a journal article must be better than most of the other submissions by both students and experienced authors. You can see from such comparisons that the process of turning a dissertation chapter into a publishable journal article is more challenging than it first appears. So now let's see how to do it properly. I'm going to use my master's thesis as an example. First, you want to identify one or more target journals by looking at the references cited in your dissertation chapter. The journals where similar work has been published are good candidates to consider for your paper. In my case, some of the journals I cited included Ecology, Estuaries, and Soil Science. Next, check out each journal's aims to see which ones best correlate with the topic of your research. Also, check the journal guidelines for length, page charges, rejection rate, impact factor, and other features to narrow down the list to meet your situation. In my case, Estuaries best fit the topic of my thesis and the quality and novelty of my research. Once you've identified a target journal, prepare a template or outline using the target journal formatting guidelines. It's a good idea to read several papers from your target journal to get a general idea of their length and how they are structured. Now you must edit the chapter contents to fit the aims of the journal and formatting requirements. How much work this will entail will depend partly on whether your dissertation is written as a series of papers already formatted for journal publication or as a thesis format. Even so, some revision is likely to be necessary. In general, your paper will be shorter and more focused on key findings than your chapter. The narrative of your paper should follow a logical path. Here's my question, here's how I addressed it, and here's what I found and why it's important. The title of your paper may or may not be the same as for your dissertation or thesis. I crafted a title for my journal article that better emphasized the main focus of my study on plant morphology and its role in decomposition. Decide who will be listed as co-authors. This may be your major advisor, committee members, mentors, or fellow students. Criteria to use in consideration of authorship include substantial contribution to design or acquisition and analysis of data, writing or substantial revision of text, and ability and willingness to be accountable for the work. If you have an abstract in your thesis, use it as a placeholder until you've revised the main text. We'll come back to the abstract later. Let's consider the introduction, which should clearly place the work into the context of the broader field. This may require bringing in some material and references from your dissertation's other chapters, or even completely rewriting the introduction. The important point here is to show the reader how your work will fill a gap in knowledge, report a discovery, or settle a controversy in the field, for example. Leave out all the text that was designed to show your committee how much you know about your topic. Provide just enough background to set the stage, referencing the most relevant and recent research. My thesis, for example, had an introduction that talked about estuarine productivity and the role of decomposition rates linking primary and secondary productivity. I spent several pages describing in detail the various studies that others had conducted on plant decay. That information was not necessary for readers who were specialists in this field. Also, my thesis introduction didn't clearly emphasize the key question that my work focused on. So when preparing my manuscript to submit to a journal, I completely rewrote the introduction. The first short paragraph put the study into the broader context of plant decomposition and the role of marsh plant detritus in the maintenance of estuarine productivity. I then narrowed the focus to consider the effects of physical and biological factors controlling decomposition rates. This led finally to the role of plant morphology in influencing decay rates of marsh plants. The paper's introduction was only about 330 words, quite a bit shorter than my thesis introduction, and did a much better job of explaining why I conducted the study. The method section from your thesis may not require much editing and may be used with minor revision, for example, to shorten descriptions of techniques that are standard or well known. Give details about the study area or laboratory setup, including descriptions of study subjects, key dates, dimensions, instruments, analytical reagents, and statistical analyses. The main concern here is that the methods description provides sufficient information to allow someone else to repeat your work, but leaves out extraneous analyses or experiments that did not pan out. For example, I explained that I use live shoots rather than dead standing biomass in order to capture the initial weight loss due to leaching of water-soluble compounds. On the other hand, I conducted some chemical analyses that did not help explain my results, so I left these out of the paper. The results should report the key findings. For example, I had one main figure showing decay rates of plants with different morphologies in three different marshes. You may have done some experiments or analyses that did not help answer your main question, but that you included in your thesis. Such data should be transferred to supplemental material or omitted altogether. Redo figures and tables if necessary to meet journal requirements. Revise the discussion to strengthen interpretation of the data and comparison with previous work. Don't make the mistake of just repeating the results as discussion. If you have trouble with this, consider combining results and discussion. That's what I did with this paper. I began by describing the overall decay patterns and compared them to previous work, which showed similar decay curves. I then described how morphology influenced the observed decay patterns and discussed how the patterns compared to other work with the same species. The conclusion section should highlight the significance of your work, broader impacts, practical applications, and future research needed. In my summary and conclusions, I pointed out what new information my work provided and why it was important. I also listed future research needed to address unanswered questions. The references cited should be restricted to include the most relevant or recent sources. Remove any references to other chapters in your thesis or dissertation. You should, however, refer to your thesis to provide context for the journal article and to direct readers to additional information in the thesis that may be of interest. Finally, write an abstract that concisely describes the aim of your study, approach, key findings, and their importance to the field. Once you have the text written, proofread the manuscript carefully and ensure you followed journal instructions. Don't make the mistake of thinking that errors in grammar, punctuation, and formatting will be corrected by the journal's copy editor. The only thing that sloppy writing will accomplish is to convince the editor that you were careless. So that's a brief overview of how to prepare a thesis or dissertation chapter for publication as a journal article. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.